Manufacturing industries are categorized under the secondary sector activities. So those activities which are transform the raw material into the finished goods. So industry is a place where raw materials means unfinished materials which can't be as consumed by the consumers. These are transformed into the usable items in a finished goods. So that place is known as a industry where raw material transform into finished goods through the manufacturing processes. In all those economies of the world which are emphasizing over a manufacturing activities, secondary sector activities, these are now presently as a developed nations. As compared to the such economies which are dependent directly and indirectly dependent upon a primary sector activities. So generally presently as the those economies are more developed which are emphasizing over a secondary sector activities as compared to the primary sector activities. Why? Because through as some secondary sector activities, they can earn as a good margin, which is not as a possible through as the primary sector activities. Those economies which are exporting as their primary goods towards the other economies, their profit margin as a lesser comparatively the manufactured goods. So the process of changing the primary raw material into more usable and valuable products by utilizing the machines, human skill are known as the manufacturing. The products thus obtained are called as the secondary products like shoe, sugar, textiles, furniture, paper, tires, automobiles, etc. Manufacturing or industrialization is the basis of a country's economies, prosperous economies of a world. They are dependent upon the industrial units. Why? Because too, as the industries, the location of industries, more number of people are getting as a job opportunities. Those economies where the secondary sector activities are prominently work, efficiently as a work, they are providing us more job opportunities to their population. More job opportunities in such countries, the living standard of a people is the higher. Living standard, they are living as the luxurious life. High living standard, high per capita income, easy to eradicate the poverty. In such economies, poverty has not exist. They solve the problem of unemployment. These economies are able to solve the problem of unemployment. The share of a secondary sector in a national economy makes a country as a developed. It makes a country as a developed. As compared to such economies like as India, which has preferably depending upon the primary sector activities, agriculture and other supportive activities. So India now after independence of 70 years of Indian independence, it's still as a developing nation. But when we compare the India with the Japan, which is as a industrial giant in all over the world, that economy having as a deficiency of natural resources. Agriculture is not possible in Japan as per their island conditions. Natural resources are not existing, mineral resources are not existing still, but still as Japan is the most developed nation of the world, which is known as an industrial giant. It has importing the raw material. Japan import the raw materials from African and Asian countries. In previous chapter, we learned as 60% of India's iron, raw iron ore directly exported towards the Japan and the North Korea. Japan and North Korea to the Vishakhapatnam port. So Japan importing there, iron from India manufactured the goods and such manufactured goods it exported towards the other economies at a high rates. Those economies which are exporting as their raw materials, which are earning as a lesser margin, lesser profit margin comparatively to those economies which exporting as a finished goods. Through as a finished goods, they can earn as a good margin of profits. Good margin of profits. Poverty and unemployment, it can be as a removed by the industrialization. The age of industrialization began in a European countries at the 16th and 17th century. With the beginning of a 16th, 17th century, growth of a newer industries, they needs as a raw material, such raw material they completed to the their colonies. Their colonies. So poverty and unemployment, it can be as a removed by the industrialization. Industrialization began in a European countries in a 16th and 17th century. With the growth of a newer industries, earlier as a cotton textiles, it encouraged to make as a colonies in a Africa and Asia. That's why the Britishers make their colony as India. Through the India, they imported as some materials towards as their England, and afterwards the manufactured goods exported towards India and sold in Indian markets at high rates, which was as a more profit margin comparatively the other conditions. So now we are self-sufficient in most of the capital and consumer goods. We must export our product in international market. This openness will help our industries to produce goods, quality goods in a quality products at a lower cost, without losing our grip or control over a international market. Presently, as a world economies are interconnected through as a globalization. Whole of the world, it becomes as a global village. It's due to as a interconnection. In present scenario, not any of a economy of a world can survive as their independence. They are dependent on a They are interdependent on each other, neither as a China, Russia, or either as a America. They can't independently surviving over a world economies. No doubt, China has not importing their goods, but for a selling purposes, it needs as a market. That market has easily available in a Central Eastern Asian countries, Southeastern Asian countries like India. In such countries, they are exporting their materials and selling at the higher in number, through which they earn as a more profit margin. So that's why as all the countries are interdependent. Some countries are required a goods like as India, which complete their 60% of a crude oil necessity from a Gulf countries like OPEC industries, OPEC countries, oil producing Eastern countries. And in such avers, these Gulf countries, which can't do as a cultivation, they importing their food grains from India towards their country. So that's why as a world economies are the open market system. They are function in an open market system. They can't survive as the independently. They are interdependent on each other. Presently, the share of a manufacturing sector, secondary sector in a GDP as the 17%. Share of secondary sector in GDP of India as the 17%. But as per the necessity of a job opportunities, there is a vast scope of a growth of a employment opportunities in secondary sector and the tertiary sector as compared to the primary sector, which make as to fulfill the developmental goals of India, through which the India it will become as a developed nation. Yes, Divyansh. So this was as a regarding our chapter. Let's start our chapter. Yes, Divyansh.
Sir, ek bari ye bata do share kitna tha?
1.7. Clear. So any of an industry, they are basically as influenced by their locational factors. locational factors which are influencing as a location of any of a industry. There are two types of locational factors are there, geographical and non-geographical. Geographical and non-geographical. Non-geographical. Geographical and non-geographical. Geographical factors include land, labor, environment, climate, land, labor, climate, raw material, availability of water, regular supply of power, next, market, nearness of market, growth of means of transport, means of transport are associated with the topography. They are associated with the geographical factors. Non-geographical factors are capital investment, because presently as a, all the industrialists, they are borrowed the money on a credit from the banks for investment purposes, or either the money which has invested from the foreign, it is known as FDI, foreign direct investment. Before of 1990s, Government of India restricted the foreigners to invest their money in an Indian subcontinent, in Indian economy. Reason, competition. If the foreigners set up their industrial units in India, it gave as a strict competition to the Indian goods. Those Indian goods at that time, which were the low graded. So foreign direct investment. But after 1990s, when the government opted the liberalized the policies of a government through which as they encourage the foreigners to invest the money in our country. No doubt through the such industries, competition increased, but in the other side, government also supported towards the public sector companies, through which as a competition, in a positive manner, competition, Indian goods, they improved their standards. For example, when the Nike, Adidas, Lee Cooper, such kind of a brands introduced in a shoe, as compared to this, the traditional local brands of a Lakhani, Bata, they also are the compete with them, through which as a Indian goods, they improve their standards. Same as Clear Amritpal, in automobiles, when the competition increased by the foreign vehicles, with this as a domestic industries, they also make as a changes in a automobiles, like as the Bajaj. So next, as the government policies, liberalization has categorized under the government policies. It is the part of a non-geographical factors. Factors which are affecting as a location of any of our industries. Any of our industry in our country are the factors. So let's start from the first, land. Land, a vast surface area required for a location of an industry. Location of industry. Large extensive surface area required for a location of industries. For the location of industries, preferably as a barren lands or less cultivated lands are used, neither as a those lands which are more fertile, because the industries, once they lean, it can function for a number of years, number of decades. So for which as a leveled land desirable for a location of industries, they can't locate on a undulating surfaces in a mountainous areas, they can't be as a setup. When we're talking about the large scale industries, they are preferably required as a leveled surfaces of plain areas for location of industries. Second, labor. Different number of industries require as a different kinds of labor, skilled and unskilled labor. Large scale industries like as a Tesco, Tata Iron Steel Company, Cotton Textiles, they require the skilled and unskilled both kind of workforce. Unskilled workers are required in iron and steel industries for mining purposes, and skilled workforce required for a functioning of machines, running of machines. Clear? Labor. So for this, as a most number of industries are located in such areas where population density is a higher. High density of a population available, through which as cheaper labor available for a production activities. If labor is cheaper than the industries, they will earn as a good margin of a profit. Then they will locate as a industries in such areas which are most populous areas or nearer to it. That's why the most number of industries are concentrated in such parts where the population living in a larger in number, like adjoining to the Delhi as a Noida and Gurgaon. Like northeast, like in a Calcutta, near in a Calcutta, in Jamshedpur, in Bhilai of Orissa, industries are concentrated because of availability of a cheaper population, cheaper labor from Orissa, West Bengal, Bihar, and Jharkhand. Next is a climatic conditions. Third is a climatic conditions. Different types of industries require as a different types of climatic conditions. For example, cotton textiles are preferably located in such areas which are having as a moisture in their air, moisture, humidity in air, humid weather conditions. Why? Because humid weather conditions are supportive for a strengthening of a thread. In some of the industries, such kind of a humid weather conditions are marked as artificially, but it will be as needs more money, capital investment. Naturally, as humidity has lies in coastal regions. That's why our India's 90% of cotton textiles are located in Gujarat and Maharashtra, especially in parts of Bombay, Ahmedabad, Vadodara, Raikot, Rajkot, Ahmedabad, in such parts where the humid weather conditions are prevailing due to the nearness of a water body. Clear? But as compared to this, other industries are located near those industries which are required as dry weather conditions, like iron and steel. Iron and steel, if the humid weather conditions are there, iron, it will be rusted. So iron and steel industries are located in such areas which are experienced as dry weather conditions. Clear? Climate as an important factor affecting as a location of industries. Under influence of a climate, the favorable climatic conditions, moderate climatic conditions are preferred by the population for living. If the moderate weather conditions are there, population is more, then in such areas, the cheaper labor, it will be available. So climate is also one of the important factors affecting as a location of industries. Clear? All the industries, any of our industries, has keeping all these points in their mind for the location of a industry. If the labor, for example, if the iron and steel industry located in somewhere outskirts of Delhi, they can as importing the materials from Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Orissa, West Bengal, Madhya Pradesh towards the Delhi, no doubt. But at that time, if the land is not available, land is more expensive. As you're familiar, in Delhi and the adjoining parts, land is very expensive. In such areas, if the more resources are spending on land, how can as industrialists, if they can manage their other number of requirements like as power, market, transport, water, raw material, and other. Clear? Labor, giving a service to the labor. So they will try to locate their industries in such areas where land available as cheaper in cost, labor available in abundance in cheaper, climate as favorable, raw material nearest to it. Raw material. If the raw material imported from the far away areas towards as industry, it will increase as cost of production. If the iron and steel industry located as nearer to the Delhi in Uttar Pradesh, they will import the material from Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, more cost of production for transportation. Transportation with charges bad jayenge. Then such kind of a product, it will be as expensive. Because all the products which are manufactured and released from industries, they are selling on a MRP. MRP. At the MRP, the consumers, they are buying such goods. It has includes all those expenses which are spent for a manufacturing of a that particular product. So raw material, it should be as located as nearer to the industry. Next is your water. So presently, as the most number of industries are required as a water in a larger in quantities. In cotton textiles, water required for a dyeing and washing purposes. In iron and steel industries, thermal power stations, nuclear power stations, water required for a cooling purposes. So nearness of a water, it should be as a mandatory, but this is not considered as a primary factors responsible for a growth of industries. Water, it can be as a bring towards the certain areas to the pipes. Clear? Next as a power, regular supply of power is a more important for a location of industries. For location of industries. If the power supply is not regular, then it will be impact over a production. Because the industrialist, if the workers are reaching at the industrial site, if the power supply is not there, how can a machinery, it will be work? But industrialist has to pay the salaries to those workers which are ready to the work. So regular supply of power mandatory for a growth of an industry, the location of industries. That's why the most number of industries are located nearer to the dams, the location of our dams, or either those regions where the coal is available in abundance. Coal available in abundance. That's why the iron and steel industries located in parts of Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, and Odisha. Coal, they can easily import it directly from mines towards the industry for the source of power. Source of power. So power is also an important factor affecting as location of industries. Location of industries. Next, as a market, goods are manufactured. Goods manufactured by the industrialists. Now, if they will not as selling in a market, then how can they will earn the profits? Then the basic motive, objective of a location of industries, it will be, it can't be as achieved, means as a profit. So markets, it should be as available, and the demand of that particular good which has manufactured in industry, it should be in a market through which the industrialist, they will encourage for the more investment for a more production. Nearness of market is a required. Presently, as a most number of perishable goods like as a bread, biscuit, they have to consume in a shorter tenure of time. If the markets are not associated with the industry, in such areas, such kind of industries are not located. And last, as a transport, means of transport, well network of a means of transport, they are supportive for the location of industry. Importing the material from the raw material from production sites towards the industry, afterwards the manufactured goods selling towards the sending towards the market, for which as well network of a means of transport, they are mandatory. So presently, as a roadways and a railways are considerably, they are preferably used for a transport purposes for growth of industries, for location of industries. These are of the geographical factors which are directly has impact over the location of industries. When J.N. Tata, Jamshedji Nasirwanji Tata, trying to decide as the which location is the favorable for location of India's first iron and steel company, it keeping the all these points in their mind. Land surface areas of Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh at present supportive as a leveled areas, labor easily available from the such kind of a population. Here we are talking about a pre-independence. At that time, Bangladesh was part of India. Large number of the workforce, cheaper workforce easily available from Bangladesh, existing Bangladesh, the Bengal province. Climatic areas as it has lies under the leeward sides of eastern ghats, dry weather conditions. Raw material available from parts of Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Orissa, West Bengal. Water available from Subarnarekha or either from the Damodar River. Power supply from the Damodar Dam or either as a coal importing from the West Bengal, Raniganj mines of West Bengal. Market as a selling towards the different parts of a country. Iron used for a export of material directly towards the other countries to Calcutta port and Vishakhapatnam port. So all these points keep in mind by the JN Tata for the location of Tata Iron Steel Company. These two are as the secondary capital investment. Capital required in location of industry as the important. As important. Capital required for a purchasing of a payment of a salaries to their workers, to their laborers, capital required for the location of a industries. So capital investment in an industrial sector has a basic component, which has also directly influence over the location of industries. Next has a government policies. Government has to support it for the location of a industries. Presently, as in a present scenario, owners or the others invest the money at their state. So government is also as the supportive for the location of a industries. Industrialists are preferred to locate as their industries in such areas where government is supportive for growth of a industries. Growth of industries. Government has directly as a supportive through the availability of an infrastructure. Well, network of a roadways and a railways developed by the government. Government has providing the public facilities. Public facilities. So government has to support it for the location of industries.